Hello, welcome to Recap Rhapsody. Today, I will bring you a classic Western movie, Rio Bravo, released in 1959. The movie follows a small-town sheriff in the American West. John T. Chance enlists the help of a disabled man, a drunk, and a young gunfighter in his efforts to hold in jail the brother of the local bad guy. With 8/10 rating points on IMDb, this is a Western movie worth for watching.
Whippoorwill in the willow sings a sweet melody.
Riding to Amarillo.
Amarillo.
Just my rifle, pony, and me.
No more cow,
no more cow
to be roping,
to be roping.
No more stray,
no more stray
will I see
round the bend,
round the bend.
She'll be waiting,
she'll be waiting.
If you want to watch the full movie, it's available for rent on Google Play, iTunes, Vudu, Amazon, and HBO Max. Warning, spoiler, please consider before viewing. The movie opens with Joe Burdett, the spoiled younger brother of wealthy land baron Nathan Burdett, taunts down drunk dude by tossing money into a spittoon. The sheriff, John T. Chance, stops dude from reaching into the spittoon, prompting dude to lash out and knock Chance unconscious. Joe starts to beat dude for fun, shooting and killing an unarmed bystander who attempts to stop him. Chance recovers, follows Joe into Nathan's personal saloon, and, with help from a penitent dude, overcomes Nathan's men and arrests Joe for murder. Chance's friend, Pat Wheeler, attempts to enter town with a wagon train of supplies and dynamite, but has to force his way through Nathan Burdett's men. Chance reveals that he, dude, who used to be a deputy before he became a drunk, and his old crippled deputy, Stumpy, are all that stand between Nathan's small army and Joe, whom they wish to free. Chance notices young gunslinger Colorado Ryan in Wheeler's wagon train, but Colorado promises he doesn't want to start any trouble. That night, Carlos Robante, the owner of the local hotel, warns Chance that Wheeler is trying to recruit fighters. Chance tries to stop Wheeler, not wanting anyone to get hurt on his account. Wheeler asks if Colorado could help, but Colorado declines, feeling that it's not his fight. Chance then notices a rigged card game at the hotel. Recognizing one of the players as a wanted woman, Feathers, the widow of a cheating gambler, he confronts her. However, Colorado reveals that another player is the cheater. Out in the street, Wheeler is gunned down. Chance and Dude pursue the killer into Nathan's saloon, and Chance allows Dude to prove himself and confront the killer, earning the respect of Nathan's men. Colorado and the rest of Wheeler's men are forced to stay in town to await a court order releasing Wheeler's possessions, and the wagons are left behind the Burdett warehouse. After Feathers secretly stays up all night with a shotgun to guard Chance, an irritated Chance orders Feathers to leave town for her safety. She refuses, and the two begin to bond. Nathan himself rides into town. Stumpy, having old grudges against Nathan for taking his land, threatens to shoot Joe if any trouble starts around the jail. In response, Nathan has his saloon musicians repeatedly play El Diguelo, Akea, the cutthroat song. Colorado realizes the song means Nathan will show no mercy and warns Chance. Chance gives Dude back his old guns and some clothes and a black hat he left behind when he became a drunkard, and Dude gets a shave, trying to start afresh. Unfortunately, Stumpy doesn't recognize Dude when he returns and shoots at him, shattering Dude's nerves. The next day, Dude is still shaky and finds himself ambushed by Birdity's men, who threaten to kill him unless Chance lets Joe go. Colorado and Feathers distract the men long enough for Chance to get his rifle, and he and Colorado shoot down the men and free Dude. Dude thinks about quitting and letting Colorado take his place, but when he hears El Degello being played, he resolves to see the thing through to the end. Dude and Chance return to the hotel so Dude can take a bath, but Birdity's men capture Carlos' wife, Consuelo, and use her to lure Chance into a trap. Dude tells Chance to take the men to the jail under pretext that Stumpy would let Joe out. However, Stumpy opens fire, as Dude secretly predicted. In the chaos, some men drag Dude off to Nathan, who demands a trade, Dude for Joe. Chance agrees, but brings Colorado as backup. Dude and Joe brawl during the trade, and a firefight ensues. Stumpy throws some sticks of dynamite from the wagons into the warehouse, where Burdette and his men are holed up, and Chance detonates them with his rifle, abruptly ending the fight. With both Burdettes and their few surviving gunmen in jail, Chance is able to finally spend some time with Feathers and admit his feelings for her. Colorado volunteers to guard the jail, allowing Stumpy and Dude to enjoy a night out in the town. Video is over now. Thanks for watching.